good, everybody? What I got before you today is a Addlink Addgame M.2 solid state drive with a heatsink built in. This one right here, you can pick this up from Amazon. As you can show right here, it's compatible. This particular one is compatible with PlayStation 5. And this model is the A92. As you can see in the box, it's a 1 terabyte. It comes with a nice heatsink with it already. And it's a very nice shiny box. And the description right here in the back, it's a PCIe Gen 4x4 with an NVMe 1.4 SSD, the M.2 2280. And because right here it shows you got the heatsink, it's compatible with the PlayStation 5. It should keep it at least 17% cooler. And show you right here the heat conducting silica gel pad, and it's a 3D NAND DDR catch. And this should be great. This should be a great internal SSD. And let me see what else it says right here in the back. It says anything additional. Okay. And it shows right here, boom. The read speed on the PlayStation 5 should be at least 5,600 megabits per second. For, in my mind, this is a mid-tier M.2 SSD. Reason why I'm saying this is a mid-tier M.2 SSD, because they got the Gen 3s that start at over 3000 megabits per second in read speed. So that's like the lowest right now, the lower tier. This is the Gen 4, which is the newest technology. The start read speed is like at 5000. So this is considered a mid-tier in my opinion. And you got several out there which is at 7000 read speed, 7000, but in reality the PlayStation 5 bottleneck it, so you're never going to get that speed. And just to let you guys know, if you're searching for M.2 SSD and you're looking for the highest one, you want to get the highest speed, some may say 7600, some may have say 8000 megabits per second read speed, or maybe possibly in the future 9000 megabits read speed. But the PlayStation 5 are bottlenecked, so you will never get no more. From the time I've been using internal SSD, you will not get nothing higher when it's finished formatting at over 6500 megabits per second read speed. That's the highest I ever got, and I tested quite a few, even though internal SSD that said they're gaming and the read speed is over 7600, near 8000. And then when I format it, the highest I ever got, like I said, is 6500. So I guess PlayStation 5 bottlenecked at the highest, 6500. And until they send out a software update that can let you use more. Will they do that? We'll never know. Anyhow, before I test this bad boy out, I'd like to tell you guys, if you're new to the channel, you can go ahead and subscribe. Don't forget to leave your likes and leave your comments. As you can see, this is brand new. I haven't opened it yet. It's still got the Addlink. It's still got the Addlink tape on the box. So I'm gonna open it nice and gentle. Okay, let me go right here. Nice and easy. Let me remove the tape right here. Nice and easy. Boom. Let's see what's inside this beautiful box. And it's very shiny. I like shiny things. It looks very shiny. Okay, so let's see right here. Let's take a look inside. There's nothing in the box. And it comes with a very thin booklet. It comes with a limited warranty. It does not say if it's what kind of warranty, if it's a 5-year warranty like most of them do. So as I show right here, if you're gonna use it for your Windows PC, these are the Windows version that it supports. Which I think is pretty cool. And to let you know right off the bat, you got the X70, X95, Spider X4. These are the model for your PC desktop. And they show right here the X95. I'm gonna see if I could get it and do a speed test on this one. And that's pretty much it for the manual. And this is the board right here. Whoa, this looks very cool. This heatsink, it kind of remind me of a heatsink that I reviewed. I don't remember the name, but yeah, this looks cool. I like this. You see right here, you got right here, it shows you made in Taiwan, 1 terabyte M.2 PCIe Gen 4x4. All right, this looks cool. Look at the design. Very simple. Got this very thick thermal padding, which I like. I don't like the thin, flimsy one. They feel like garbage. And I don't think the thin one provides much cooling. And look at this. Very nice in design. Look futuristic. Almost like a, look like one of those things you see on a gaming PC or anything related to gaming. And boom, as you can see right here, that's all. This right here shows right here is a SK Hynix. Oh, okay, SK Hynix. I've seen that before. Boom, all right. And I think with most of these, they don't want you to remove these this sticker right here or avoid a warranty. Like I said, I did not see what kind of warranty it comes with, but this is it right here. The Addlink Addgame PCIe 4th Gen internal SSD. And this one is mid-tier because according to the box, read speed is 5 over 5,000 megabits per second. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put it in the PlayStation 5, I'm gonna format it, and I'm gonna do some speed tests with some games real quick, all right? So let's get into it. All right, before I do a speed test with this amazing Addlink Addgame internal SSD with a heatsink, I'm gonna put it inside the PlayStation 5 to show you guys that it fits. I got some videos with some heatsinks that I did that fits inside the PlayStation 5. You would also see which one you like, and I'll go on Amazon or Walmart, wherever you wanna go, and buy the heatsinks. I got videos that I test to see which heatsinks fit inside the PlayStation 5 when you install the thermal padding and the heatsink onto your internal SSD. So as you can see, this one fits perfectly fine. I'm gonna add the lid onto it. See, no, it doesn't raise or anything. It's very flush. Awesome. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm gonna go ahead, fire this bad boy up, and then we're gonna do the formatting and do some speed tests. Okay, we're now away at the screen, and what we're gonna do right now, we're gonna format this M.2 SSD, and I'm gonna show you the read when it's fully formatted. And this one again is an Addlink Addgame A92. With the heatsink. So let's go ahead and format it and see what kind of read speeds we get. Oh wow, read speed, wow. Let me just zoom in real quick for you guys so you can see it. This is pretty impressive. 5633 megabits per second. That is pretty cool. I like that. So let's go back out here a little bit. Okay. So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to move over God of War from the console onto this amazing the internal SSD right here. So let's see if we could go ahead and move it right now. This should be a very fast process. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm gonna move the game from the storage onto the console. So here we go. Let me get my stop clock up here. I'm gonna see how fast it's gonna do it. Okay, M.2 SSD, Addlink, move God of War 45 gigabit game from the internal SSD to the console storage. And the speed test is going to begin at 3, 2, 1, go. So God of War has moved from the M.SSD back onto the console. So show it back right here. It's back on the console, and it takes it approximately 3 minutes and 23 seconds to move the God of War 45 gigabyte game from the internal SSD back to the console. So that's pretty fast. I'm impressed with that. Let's do this bad boy real quick. Let's see how fast it's gonna take to boot it up. insert, let me clear my clock first. It's going to be in 3, 2, 1, go. So right there, boom, in 31 seconds. Overall, I think this Addlink Addgame internal SSD is very good. I'm very impressed with it. I like it personally. But what I'm gonna do right now, which I'm gonna start before I conclude my videos, I'm gonna get my little trusty gun right here. I'm gonna see how warm this bad boy is. Feel it? So they're saying this bad boy is at least 90, at least 100 degrees Fahrenheit, which is cool. Let me go to the back of it real quick and scan it. So show the back. It's pretty much the same thing, 100 degrees Fahrenheit, which is pretty cool. I personally like it. I like it very much. I like the design. I like the way it comes with a very thick thermal padding in the middle. So that's it. That concludes the video. And if you like it, go ahead and like it up. I would really appreciate it. It helped my video get noticed in the system. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and share with anybody else. All right. What I'm gonna do right now, not right now, what I'm gonna do in the future, I'm gonna get more of these mid-tier internal SSD, and I'm gonna do a speed test between them to see which one is the fastest, and I'm gonna try to compile them onto a list and put them on a chart to show them the top mid-tier Heatsinks to the bottom of the barrel Heatsinks. And then in my next video, if you subscribe and if you hit the notification bell, I'm getting a new internal this week. It's the Acer Predator, so look out for that video. And the Acer Predator is a top tier internal SSD, and I don't think you guys want to miss that one. So I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out.